Thank you all very much. Thank you all for coming tonight. Good to see everybody out. Good to see our new commissioners. We are coming off of some very extensive training in Lexington for the newly elected officials, and then there was quite a bit of information that was updated, you know, from last year. So we're all a little more well-learned than normal.
Or if we're not, we can look it up.
That's we know where to look.
And that book.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Yes. We normally, guys, would approve our minutes from the previous meeting, but we did that at a special meeting. And I don't have the minutes from the special meeting done, so we skipped number two. Number three, because Jennifer was gone last week, she didn't have the time to get the financial statements and treasurer's reports done. So we skipped number three. And on the number four, we need to discuss who goes where over the departments for the various departments of the city. And with the commission's approval, I would like to nominate Gary to be over our wastewater operations. He's has a vast experience with water and wastewater. And I think he would be an asset to Jim and could help the city. Do I need that in a motion, Amy?
Yeah, probably.
All right. So can I have a motion? Tammy, thank you, Tammy. And do I have a second?
Sure.
Harold seconds. Thank you, Harold. And all those in favor, say aye. And opposed, like sign, no. All right. The sanitation, I would like to nominate Commissioner Green to be over the sanitation. He has been with the commission 22 years. This is his now 23rd year beginning. And he knows a lot.
Already.
Is that right? Since 1995, wasn't it? Okay, 95 is when you started, January 95?
93, I think it was.
Okay.
We served 3 years first time. That's why I had long, something, I don't know what it was, changing or some major thing up there. We served 3 years first time.
I'll be darned, yeah. So do I have a motion to put Commissioner Green over the cemetery?
I make the motion.
Well, what?
Sanitation.
Sanitation, sorry.
Yes. What's that consist of?
Garbage.
Oh.
Trash pickup.
Okay.
See you right, don't you?
John. And all those in favor?
Not in favor.
All right. The next two are big ones, and Tammy, I think you can multitask, so I want to put you, name you on the cemetery.
Okay, you have to tell me. I mean, okay, but what is that consist of?
That is helping us with the planning of the cemetery, helping us to organize.
Making sure it's taken care of. It's,
yeah.
Sowing grass on dirt spots.
Yeah, I'm getting ready to, I'll introduce a gentleman.
Now, you know, when it gets warm, I'm always looking for something to do. And I got a pressure washer for Christmas, so I could be dangerous.
Oh, boy. Well, good. Very good. So I will entertain a motion to put Commissioner Scott over the cemetery.
I'll motion.
And the second, Commissioner Green. All those in favor? All right.
So now, is there a map or?
Yes, very extensive.
We'll have to make a plan to get. Are you laughing, Jimmy?
Just the extensive map comment you made.
If you want to come in, we can sit down and go over it, and I'll show you what I do with the cemetery and go from there.
Okay. Because if I'm going to do it, I want to know what's
right.
What it is and.
Right. It is. next to the wastewater system. It's probably the next biggest asset of the city. And it is the most sensitive, as you would imagine. And it requires the most attention to detail. Nothing against the wastewater, but the cemetery does need more detail. And we can, well, you'll soon hear a story about that. Streets and sidewalks, I will nominate Commissioner Pollock to go over the streets and sidewalks. I will entertain a motion to put John over streets and sidewalks. Tammy, I'm here, Commissioner Scott, Commissioner Green, and all those in favor. And with that, your duties, John, beginning ASAP, I'm going to want you to start looking over the streets. You can get with Public Works Director Hoskins, surveying the streets, and start putting a list together of the places that we need fixed. You can consult with Commissioner Green there. He's been over streets and sidewalks for years. But I would like to have a package together of a specifications to put out for bid by our next meeting in February, because I want to get this thing bid as soon as possible so that the companies that bid on it can get to work on it hopefully by April. That's the plan. All right, moving right along. The riprap around the upper lagoon. I don't know, Tammy, if I talked to you about that, John. Really not much we can say tonight. I mean, I'll tell you. The Division of Water requests that we clean all extra vegetation around. You probably know that, don't you, Gary? All around the lagoons, the ponds. And when that happens, the ground erodes. So they recommend that we riprap it all around the, I guess, eventually to be all around the lagoon.
Oh, good.
Yeah. And
that is that, like that net stuff?
It's a big rock.
Big rock.
Oh, okay.
You see what you see is rock, but there's net.
And holds that, stabilizes that bank. And the gentleman that had confirmed that he was going to put in a bid is out of town and didn't get his estimate to us. All right, the next one in old business is the contract with the Trimble County Water District number 1, and I will hand that off to our city attorney, Eversole.
Well, as an introduction, I'm sure you all know that Trimble County Water District gave us notice that they were going to terminate the contract and be effective January 27th, so they sent a new proposed contract, and this is just the resolution authorizing it. Resolution authorizing mayor to enter into contract with Trimble County Water District number 1, whereas the city of Bedford, Kentucky is desirous of obtaining water service for its residents, and Trimble County Water District number 1 has the capability of providing a safe and sanitary water supply. Whereas the previous contract between the City of Bedford, Kentucky and Trimble County Water District No. 1 will terminate January 27, 2017, after notice from Trimble County Water District No. 1. Whereas the Commission of the City of Bedford, Kentucky believes it is in the best interest of its residents to enter into a new contract with Trimble County Water District No. 1 for the supplying of water services. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the City of Bedford that the mayor is authorized to enter into an agreement for the supplying of water services with Trimble County Water District No. 1.
Which means
they're going to continue doing what they do. The price changed. It's going to now be $433 per month. What was it before?
$100.
We tried to, they shut it down.
Right.
Is that the best they can do?
Yeah, it's a plan to reimburse them for the upgrades that they made over a certain period of time.
Well, that's a lot over.
How many customers are there?
307.
I don't, you can't get blood out of a turnip, basically. So I really don't think $2 more on the sewer bill is going to be that. I mean,
And I'm still looking into the legality of that.
That's what I feel like. I mean, that's going four times the amount in OA. That's kind of ridiculous.
Yeah. But I mean, if that's your final offer, take it or leave it.
That's exactly
right. And we can't leave it.
And we can't leave it.
Right.
I mean, you got to understand, like Tammy's saying, with 60, it's 40. I heard the other day he was telling me it's 40% of the people in Bedford property owners. 60% are not renters.
Sounds accurate.
We ain't got a lot of people here really to care about what Bedford is.
Right. Mm-hmm. And that is something that.
And that's what I worry about.
As managers of the city, I think we all are obligated to fix that.
More, and they're adding more on to us all the time. Mm-hmm. We're not getting any more people.
But yeah, the more and more we get in, then the governing body's going to switch to the majority.
Right.
And the people from here are not going to have
the majority.
No.
That's right.
I think that's why it's important.
Right now,
it's important what we do now.
Right, exactly.
So that in 20 years, that changes.
Don't get me wrong. If I lived in Louisville, I'd put footprints on somebody's back to get up here.
Sure.
But, you know, and you can't blame other people for coming.
Right. That's right. All right. I will entertain a motion to accept this resolution. Commissioner Scott, second by Commissioner Johnson. And all those in favor?
Aye.
Thank you all. I will sign it shortly.
So do we have to write an ordinance to add the $2 onto the sewer bill?
Yes, we will have to change the billing if it's legal.
We have to double check because with utilities, there are certain regulations that are separate.
Okay.
But we have to check with KLC on.
Yeah. All right, and that brings us to new business. We need to elect a mayor pro tem. And I have always had the opinion, I know it's not law, but my opinion always was that the mayor pro tem should be the highest vote getter of the commissioners. And therefore, I would nominate Commissioner Scott to be our mayor pro tem. We got a motion, a second.
Yeah.
All right. And all those in favor?
I'm going to hire you a bodyguard. You're in.
You're there.
First lady.
First lady.
You
can't.
All right. The big, another big issue here, guys, is we need to get this straightened out with the bank so that we can all sign checks. And, this is a lengthy motion, and I'll make it. I will motion that we, and Amy, help me if I'm crazy. I will make a motion that we give the commissioners and the city clerk the authority to sign the checks for the O&M, general, cemetery, bond and sinking, discretionary, municipal road aid, depreciation fund, kids cafe, and the cemetery accounts at the Bedford Loan and Deposit. Do I have a second?
I'll state that over again. I didn't catch it. I mean, there's something a little bit. Understand about that.
My motion is to give us, the commissioners and the city clerk, the authority to sign the checks for the O&M, the general, the cemetery, the bond and sinking, discretionary, municipal road aid, depreciation fund, and the kids cafe, and this last one, the perpetual cemetery fund. It's all the Citibank accounts.
Well, I have a little problem with that.
Okay.
She's not elected official.
Right.
I'm saying I'm against you now. These all been elected officials. They're responsible for the city.
Yeah.
They're responsible, not her.
Right.
Something goes wrong. Who's going to take the blame?
Well, she would. Yeah, she would.
Well, I mean, she.
And we have bonded.
They're going to look to her.
Yeah, they would too.
They're gonna look at us because she don't have any, you know, what to call power in is in the.
Who signed the last check? So it was an office.
You've been not able to do this, but you. Two. I mean, thing.
Yeah,
is,
yeah, it's a two check. Two people signed.
That's what I see about it.
Yeah, it's two people signing.
Who's the current treasurer?
Me.
Yeah. All right, that's my motion. I'll entertain a second.
I'll second that motion.
All those in favor? All right. And opposed? It's 4-1. All right. And now, moving along.
And that's two signatures,
yes,
every check.
For every check, yes. We need to select a resident to serve on the a voluntary position with the PBA. Jennifer, you know a little more about that probably than I do.
Not really. It's just someone to sit on the board to talk about the taxes and the rates and for the city.
Okay.
I don't know when the meetings are held, but I can find out more information tomorrow.
All right. Do y'all have anybody in mind?
It can be anyone. It was Betty.
Betty Temple.
Betty Temple.
Yeah.
She's done it for years.
Remember?
Yeah.
She'd be great. She'd be good.
Yeah, but I don't think she wants to do anything.
I don't think she wants to.
She does.
Yeah.
I know she does.
Yeah.
She'd be good.
Had over
a fact she does.
Yeah. Yeah, she's a good person.
And do they have to reside in the city limits?
Yes.
Okay. All right.
And is anybody, I mean, has anybody expressed any interest in doing it?
They just told us that we needed to elect someone.
When do we
just recently?
When do we need to find that person?
I think we could get away with waiting until February,
yeah,
couldn't we?
So not say we table.
Yeah, she's not in.
We could be thinking until the next meeting.
Right. We'd
find somebody to be interested in.
All right. We have a motion on the floor to table this. Do you have a date until when?
I'd say until the next regular meeting.
Okay.
To give us time to figure out who it's going to be.
And all the details to it.
All right, and we have a second, and
yeah,
then
and
all
find
those
out
in favor. All right.
Ask around, see if there's anybody.
Yeah, there might be some people interested. The next one, guys, is I want to look at the personnel policies again. Once a year, I've been going through, and or at least the last 2 years, and revising them. This is not something that's pressing. And that's only a portion of them. We'll get you the whole thing. I'd like to get it done by June or July. But I thought if I'd give it to you tonight, we would get started on that. And then, moving along, I would like to introduce you all to David Richmond. David takes care of the cemetery. He mows for us. He fills graves. He works year-round at the cemetery. So, David, the floor is yours, sir.
All right, well,
wherever you'd like.
Well, I'm on the cemetery for 14 times a year. And I don't know how many hours it is. We mow, we trim, we clean flowers, we do graves, we trim bushes. And if we have any problems in that time, then we'll probably be the Todd or you, and we'll get together and get it worked out. I live on Shepherd Lane, so it's a few minutes away. I've done it for, I don't know how many years.
5 or 6.
3 years. And we've got to put, I got $3 million worth of liability insurance. So, and it is a year-round job. Right now we have some graves out there that sunk, which needs to be filled. There's people that it dries up. I was out there last week, got flowers off the grave. There's always flowers scattered around to pick up. Probably we don't have any problems, but every once in a while, get on somebody's phone, but me too. So when they come to Todd, you can get together and get it taken care of. I'd like to talk to you about that.
Yep.
It's green in. Thank you for watching your evening too. So I'll do my best and I'll do work year round. Anything you need done, this is the best time.
That's a big job.
Yes, it is. Yes,
we appreciate
thank you, Dave.
And I'll give you my phone number here shortly.
Yep. And
maybe I can be somebody else's phone number.
And the next one I want to introduce, if you all probably already know him, is Jim Hoskins. He's our public works director. I'm sure you all know him. But Jim, would you stand up and say a few words?
Good
Tell us about what's been going on with the wastewater treatment plant.
You want to update on that now?
Yeah.
Okay. I have to say, I've been around here, what, this 3 years now. Been licensed since 96. I've done industrial. I've also done private. Now, done municipality. A lot of changes in wastewater. Everybody thinks it's top, you flush it, it's gone. That ain't the case. There's always some regulatory person wants to get involved. And it's getting worse now since 2013. I think this portion of people that govern my work is called Homeland Security. And there's a lot of the people in my field think within 3 years there won't be a Division One. We'll be working for Homeland Security. And I'm going to agree with them because just about every time we come into a problem, your engineer, my engineer, not here, he'll be here somewhere, we'll go to Division Water. How come? They're typical lanes. The feds told us to. So, the writing's on the wall. A lot more training. We're getting emails on everything. Talk about that here in a minute, I guess. But as far as the system, we're running pumps that's 32 years old. Not every lift station, we have four lift stations. We have one out here across from the old water company. We have one down here on Town Branch. We have one over here behind the courthouse. And we have a new one, 2008 model, at the nursing center. It's sad, it's got a new one out there. The only thing it pumps is nursing center stuff. It's not pumping anything else. The problem is with your system here is it's 32 years old. The piping is in decent shape. The pumps and stuff are not. Getting parts for them, you can't do it. We have been lucky. MSD and Mobile had some stuff and some underground bunkers and stuff. And we went in there and we stole rock parts off of them to keep ours going. That's piles getting smaller and smaller is what we can get. So at some point, you know, probably while you all are still sitting in the positions, we're going to have to start buying some stuff. And every time I say that, she starts creeping up. So,
is there grants out there that we can apply for?
Very few. However, we as operators are under the understanding the more, that's the good part of Homeland Security, the more they get involved, the more money's going to be involved for grants and stuff. Basically, right now, grants and stuff is just flat. They've got them little pissy hands, $2,000 grants they give out every year. That's just, here's a piece of candy, go away. The small grants are about the only thing they're available.
There is heard big FEMA anymore?
No. I'll touch base on it real quick in a minute. But the pumps we are able to run, right now we have one pump down in the lift station number one out there. It's due to electrical part that we can't get anymore. We've reached out to some people that's updated. Maybe they kept some of that stuff. So far, we have not found anything. We have some electrical stuff that's not manufactured anymore. That pump will run if I go and run it manually. There's two pumps in every station. Right now, that one pump's keeping up just fine. In the event that it don't, then I'll have to sit down and run it manually until at some point this other one will come up. And that has happened. It's been 17 hours, this one down here last year.
So you don't have an extra pump for each station?
No, sir. Do not have any pumps extra for any stations. That's your lift stations. Like I say, pipe is in pretty good shape. Your plant's in pretty good shape. Your plant, I have not done an analysis on it in almost a year. Probably need to do it now. It was, you were at 47% capacity at the treatment plant. And we was at 53% capacity at the lift stations. So, we can't get bigger with what we got. We're going to have to upgrade, mainly the pumps.
What kind of money is that?
Well,
$1.5 million.
Big money.
Yeah. They quoted us one pump from a vendor last year, $22,000 dropped on the ground here.
great thing about the internet was I got on there and played, found one in Canada, and paid like $50, $200, something like that for it, and I put it in myself. A lot of maintenance I can do myself, guys, and I do. Some of the maintenance I can't. It requires 1 to 4 people. At that point, we have a contractor we call, and he's usually here within the hour.
Can them pumps be overhauled at a cheaper
rate? What has happened is they have been overhauled so many times.
Oh.
The casing, you know, you overhaul this part, makes the clearance. You know how it's important. Yeah. You overhaul this so many times, this has got so big, it's not overhauled no more. And that's where we're at.
Commissioner Scott, to kind of what he's talking about. Right after I took over as mayor, I started exploring the idea of expanding the wastewater system to go out past the library and Poppies. And although that land, for the most part, is vacant right now, there is some new houses down Purcell, and then there are several houses down Purcell that we could pick up. That project is still on the books, and that is one that if you all are interested,
if it was sewer, it'd be a potential for somebody to buy.
Absolutely. More chances to develop it.
They could buy it for development. The sewer's over there.
Mm-hmm. And I think it would better the whole town that way. Not just the sewer, but if you guys are interested in that, that is something that I will call Kipta in the morning and say, yes, we're still interested, or no, we're not.
Well, I say go for it.
And one of the things that held us up, or didn't hold us up, Kentucky Infrastructure Authority said, we'll loan you the money right now. The USDA, who we have our other loan with, said, we'll loan you the money right now. But our engineer said, wait a minute, and Kipta said, there are grants, but it takes a long time to get them. And it was 12th on the list, and I understand now it's moved up to 4th, but it's still a ways to go.
But we'd have to, would we need upgrades to be able to expand like that?
And that's part of that price tag.
That's part of it. The biggest thing you'd be looking at is an additional lift station.
Yeah, but the rest of it would be.
Do we have somebody that writes grants?
We have a gentleman, our engineer, is working on all that. Yeah.
Do all the lift stations have different horsepower pumps?
Ours does.
There's none of the two same pumps in any?
No.
Out
of all four lift stations we have, I can't move one pump from one to another.
So you can't buy one spare and plug it in?
No.
So you got to have one for each?
All four of them.
I got you.
And that would be nice.
Yeah.
Yes, you need that.
It was a surprise to me too, when I went and looked at it. Right?
Yeah, that's you need that. One goes down, put the other one in.
Oh, the same.
Right.
Do I need a motion for that?
Just to have you contact him?
Yeah.
Money.
You're not actually changing anything or committing to anything now.
Right, we're just moving forward.
Getting information.
We all agree that we want to move forward.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Then the other thing that you all are going to face, and I'm sure you've all heard it, is this FEMA stuff. I'm going to explain it the best I can. July 2015, I believe it was.
Yep.
We had a flood. It done a lot of damage to the plant. By their estimates, and I say their FEMA estimates, FEMA come in several times, along with Paul and me and our engineer, and seems like every day somebody else wants to redo the numbers. They come up with a 400 and blank here, in excess of $400,000 worth of damage. They said we was a large scale loss. We did not get put into the little stuff. We were a large project. They told us what we had to do and all this stuff. The thing is, it is, and this is the hardest part I can get to explain across. If you don't understand it, by all means, if you don't want to say it now, catch me after me, I'll explain it to you again. It is a reimbursement package, is what it is.
They don't care that we have $400,000. They don't care if it's a $4 million. They're going to pay you. They're part of it.
After you spend it.
If you spend it and do it. They're not going to give you money up front to do it. You have to spend it to get it.
Spend it first and they'll pay.
Now.
Yeah.
And everybody's going, my billboard won't do that. They know that. So now they think, okay, they'll scale it down. They'll do it. But at the same time, they won't scale it. We can't scale it down because their specifications of how we've got to do something is what nobody else, any of y'all will do in your homes. Because they go above and beyond on their construction specs, which makes no sense. But if you want any reimbursement, you've got to follow that recipe. Todd and them pulled 53,000 out, and he said, here, get started. Because they told us that, I don't know if it was a promise, but they said we would more than likely, you spend 50,000, we'll go ahead and get you that 50,000 reimbursement, knowing we're not going to go over the threshold, okay? So, we got started. I believe we spent in the neighborhood of 40-ish thousand. And so far, we have not been reimbursed anything. We've done everything they've asked. Our engineer contacts them almost on a weekly basis. Do you need anything else? Now, that sounds real depressing until you talk to other agencies in the county. The road department, fire department, Shelby Energy. Nobody is being reimbursed anything yet. So,
did the city get a little bit?
Huh?
Did the city get it? They didn't get it? I was thinking they did.
No, we didn't get any. We have not received anything to my knowledge, have we?
No, we have not.
It's set up for a direct deposit. You probably won't know it unless you look at some banks.
No, they'll send an email.
I mean, and, the county, I was talking about the county, didn't I? That's what I meant.
You'll have to ask the county. Thank you. So that's what the FEMA stuff is. And the thing about it is that I keep telling myself and telling Todd, what if FEMA wasn't paying nothing?
That's right.
We've got to do it anyway. And they have this thing called quarterly reports that the engineer must send in on this FEMA stuff. Even though they're not giving us anything, they want a quarterly report of what you done. So, we try to do a little something that don't cost a lot each quarter to show them that, yes, we're still here. So that's basically where that is at now.
So there's still communication with them. There's still the deal.
She may go to the mail tomorrow and say, hey, we got this back in. We think it's going to be, when it's said and done, 87% reimbursement. 87 point something.
Yeah, that's about right.
So basically, everything we spend, it's going to be 12% of that we'll never get back.
Right. And this riprap we talked about earlier.
Yes, this is part of it.
That's part of the flood, too.
Yes.
And the goal, what we talked about, was because it's a reimbursement and we operate on a slim budget, we thought if we could do something every quarter just to show that we are trying, that maybe that would help. And that riprap is our next project. And we're hoping to get that done, I guess, in March.
That's the thing on the FEMA. I don't have any more information.
But you can do it in bits and pieces along the way, up to that point.
Yeah, you can do it. They'll let you do it in segments. Like, this will be the last thing we do, but I'm just going to use an example, the asphalt. There's X amount of feet of asphalt to be laid. We can't lay half of it. We have to do that piece
section
of it.
Yeah.
And what Todd is talking about is one section of that. And to better explain it, just to say this is a pond. It's washed. The creek come over here. This is now washed out up here. Yeah. Now, here's the sad part that he didn't tell you. Right here, I'm a visual person. Right here is our inlet pipe coming from town.
Okay.
Coming down to the plant after it goes through some stuff up here. This
was sticking out here about 8 feet, the end of the pipe when it went into the ponds. This is washing out here over top of this. This, Todd's got pictures somewhere, I'm guessing 10 inches tops right now before this gets to the soil. The longer we wait, the more this is coming over. And then it's going to block this up. Then I'm going to be really screaming.
Yeah, then we'll have some very bad problems all over town.
We've done cleaned that out once. We ran it back over, which the city.
How much is the rock?
It's going to approximately $12,000 to $13,000.
That's probably about what it's going to run.
Yeah,
it's going to be my estimated guess. And what they have to do, they've got to go in there. There's a large hole down there. They've got to fill it up. Per FEMA specs, then they got to come in, lay that geofabric netting there. Then they got to do all that other crap. Then the rock's the pretty part. I'll quit rattling, but as far as the wastewater stuff, if at any time you all want to go look at the plant, you want to say, hey, do we have lines in this area? Is these houses served? Is these not? Holler at me. We'll go at any time you want to go.
Or locate a line.
Locate a line. To my knowledge, there's only 3 homes in the city limits. It's not covered by sewage. It's very costly to put them on, do the rock. And they did one on at the time, and there's only 1 out of the 3 people living now. I think 2 of them are empty, right?
I think 2 of them are full.
Oh, 2 of them.
Yeah.
Somebody moved in the other house.
Okay. Dead house. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay. But those are the only ones that are not on. That's in city limits. Now, we got some outside city limits.
That are on, yeah.
That are on it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you don't have to have a, be in a city limits to have a sewer line. An example, Milton, their sewer line comes clear out to Tilly's and all of them there. Yeah, you can, if you also did, you can run a sewer line to Campbellsburg.
Mm-hmm. I have one question for you.
Okay.
That end of pipe down at the treatment plant, should that be submerged?
It is.
I mean, I thought it should be above water.
They designed that new, the original design on that, it was submerged and it went way out in there, about where that first aerator is. Supposedly, I've never seen it, I've never drained a pond. There's a concrete bulkhead out there. And it was like 4 feet from that, under 4 feet down, where it come out and get that bulkhead.
Oh, okay.
That's all probably fell over anything else.
Okay.
I'm done.
All right. Thank you very much, Jim. That's good. The next one we have, not on the agenda, and this happened earlier today. We had a lady come into City Hall who had purchased a cemetery plot in March of 2015. All she had was a receipt, and she had been coming in to ask for her deed to the plot, which is basically this. When she came in here in September of 2015, she and her sister were very, very upset. And the clerk at the time, it started into a shouting match, so I wanted to intervene. And I didn't understand exactly what she was talking about, other than I thought she was trying to buy more cemetery plots. Well, as it turns out, no, she just wanted, well, she did want to buy new ones, more plots, but she also wanted the deed to the one that she had already paid for. So today she came in to City Hall asking for her money back and to sell the plot back to the city. And do I need a motion to give her money back?
Yeah.
And we are basically buying
that. What was she so upset about?
Her sister had passed away, I want to say in 2011 or 12, and it was a sudden death. The woman was young, and they bought a cemetery plot. And it was near some other family that they had. A couple years later, I guess about 3 years later, the sisters started talking about, we all kind of like to be buried together. So they came in to approach our clerk about buying those cemetery plots. And the clerk sold them one, and all the other plots that are around where the sister is buried already belong to somebody else. And the clerk couldn't convey that message and kept putting them off. So that day when they came in last fall, or fall of 2015, they were just mad, and it got pretty loud. But I didn't understand that they had bought an extra plot and that she just wanted a deed until today. And I was just coincidentally looking over an old notepad, and I found where I wrote that she was looking for more cemetery plots. So I didn't understand either that all she wanted was this. And I told her, if I'd have known really that's what you wanted, I could have got that for you pretty quick. But I was really concerned that you were wanting to buy cemetery plots, and I wanted to find you some. But now she's decided she doesn't want this cemetery plot at all. And I told her I would take care of it and bringing it up in here tonight. And I would make that motion that we give her, give her the money back or...
Repurchase
the cemetery plot. So can I have a second on that? Thank you, Commissioner Green. I'll pass the checkbook down to you. And all those in favor? Thank you very much, guys. Don't forget to sign this check, Carol, before you leave.
Okay.
And I thank you all for taking care of that. And now, I will ask Jennifer, do you have anything?
Oh.
Amy, do you have anything?
No.
Tammy.
So everybody that buys a plot gets a deed, and we distribute those from here.
Yes. Yes. Lisa. And there's one whole filing cabinet in there that is devoted to the cemetery. I think it's rated at 700 degrees, isn't it, Harold? That fireproof filing cabinet. It's big, and the books are big.
How many graves are out there right now?
I think about 4,300, aren't there? Yeah.
You got a weeding around everyone.
It seems like 8,000.
Yeah, I bet.
Yeah, and there's and we've got, is it 3 acres that are empty? Yeah, a little over 3 acres that are empty, that we haven't started selling plots. We've got it to where we can map it out, but we haven't started selling plots there yet.
That's got to all be mapped and designed for it. Things will be with trees planted.
Right.
You'll learn that
part. Yeah, and it's good to get in on that end, and you'll see the end that you're coming in on with the other part of the cemetery is very tricky, very tricky. All right, Commissioner Johnson, do you have anything?
Well, I just think that we need to give Mr. Hoskins a new pump for each lift station. That way, when it goes down, the change you've done.
Right. He just became your best friend. And as money comes available.
Right. Well, yeah. I don't mean right now.
But I love
it. That's what needs to happen.
Yeah.
It does.
Yes, it does. Commissioner Pollock.
I don't have anything to add.
All right. Commissioner Green?
I've got a little. This has been on the agenda, I think, a long time. about cleaning up Bedford, but hey, we need something to be done.
Thank you for bringing that up.
Before anything else done. We're losing some of our people. We don't have a barber now. Don't have really a, I don't imagine, a full-time lawyer. Don't have no doctors or nothing. No, we're hurting.
You can tell we don't have a barber.
But we need to clean it up so people can be interested to come in here.
And with that,
you one time, and you have somebody on, and you're going to elect somebody to where they
code enforcement.
Yeah, go forth about these places.
Yes, and this spring he will be doing it. And yeah. and I'm glad you brought it up, Harold.
Yeah.
Because we need to add in our nuisance ordinance some language that about the code enforcement. Yeah. And that's something we'll work on. I guess to pivot from that, right now, Amy has been very busy working on the ordinance for the alcohol, because that is a very short time frame that we need to get that ordinance done. And I called ABC today, and a little after 5, they called me back.
Oh.
Yeah, and then they emailed me a whole bunch of information. I had a few questions, and the gentleman said, I'll just email you this packet. And,
okay.
Yeah.
When we were down there this week, there was a thing brought up about taxing dilapidated properties at a higher rate, and it was legal.
Right.
So I think we need to think about that. Maybe if they were going to have to pay more to leave them dilapidated, somebody might do some things about it. What are you looking at me like that for, Amy?
Well, those properties, I went to a conference, I think it was back in June, with KLC, and a lot of those people, especially rental properties, they'll say they don't have the money. What will happen? Eventually, the city will end up with those.
Okay.
And then we can sell them.
Yeah, fix them up.
You know, it doesn't take too much more effort to clean up something than it does what keep it where it is. If you clean it up, a little bit of effort every day, or maybe 2 days, or 3, or something like that. We need to do something to make people believe that we're doing something, we mean it, and you might have to take them to court sometime.
Well, the code enforcement board would handle it, and yeah. they meet, Harold, on the second Tuesdays of the month,
and
at 6:00.
If you have to, we got to get something done. We can't just keep lingering on every year and get loosened out. Places are falling down.
I would recommend you come to one of those code enforcement. We met last Tuesday night. I would recommend you come to one of those code enforcement boards, and. Right now, we're just trying to identify the properties so that come spring we can get to work on them.
Yeah.
And you might have a list too that you could give them,
yeah,
especially
yeah.
to the code enforcement officer.
We got one street we know what street
yes.
it is.
Oh yeah,
terrible.
But
terrible.
Very quickly we can think of something.
We just need to do something, boys. Mm-hmm. We're dragging our feet too much.
Yeah. It's those wheels are spinning.
You go here to Callensburg, you go to Newcastle, you go to Emmons, you go to LaGrange, or anywhere around, clean.
But they do have their problems, believe me.
Well, they got their problems, but you know they don't look like ours.
Ours, I think, is magnified because we're smaller.
Yeah, but you go around... Newcastle, it's pretty big, and it's as clean as could be over there.
Are they doing the landlord registration through us, or are they doing it through the code enforcement?
It'll come through us,
okay.
Yeah. And that's one of the things that I had talked about, was having a landlord registration ordinance.
Yeah.
And also enacting an ordinance that the city of Bedford would adopt the Kentucky State Landlord Tenant Act. But then again, this alcohol thing is taking precedence, we need to finish it up first, and then we're coming right back to the cleaning, because we've got the ordinance for the code enforcement board, and they are meeting. We have a code enforcement officer who is chomping at the bit to start issuing citations.
And it's the second Tuesday of the month.
The second Tuesday, and they meet here at 6 o'clock. And
I'm coming to that one.
Yeah, and like I said, we were compiling a list, and bring your list too, because that, you know, we can all look it together and agree, you know, on what we're looking at. And eventually, you see behind me this television that is hooked up to the internet. We will have pictures, and that'll be part of our documentation for the code enforcement, is to take pictures and say, look, this is the problem. So that when we are issuing citations and violations, that and it escalates to the point where it's in front of a circuit court judge, he's going to be more, or she would be more inclined to back us up on it, with all that documentation. And you know, the ordinance as it's written now with the nuisance ordinance, it really lacks the teeth in it that we need to have for the enforcement of it through the code enforcement. That's coming. And that'll probably be, as soon as we finish the alcohol one, we'll get it.
We'll put teeth in it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, because the state gave us the power.
More businesses in here. You know?
Yeah, absolutely.
We're losing some. We need to add them and more too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely more, and I think we'll get them. All right. And Jim.
I forgot.
Go ahead.
When I come into this job, I had a license to spray pesticides. We've been using my license ever since, but they decided that they were going to change the laws, and my license will not let me spray for you all anymore. They've got a training here. The reason I'm bringing it up is it's February the 2nd, which that'll be before you all meet back, and I need to attend that training to get my license. I need the one for aquatic pest control and the right-of-way. Those two, the price of those two is $140. And to go ahead and get the other one for the category 3, it's only $10 more. Just another test I got to take. I'd like to just do all three while I'm there. There's several sites you can go to. Georgetown, Kentucky is the closest one to us, and it will probably, it's a 12-hour, yeah, it will require a hotel stay. I'm not going to get up at 2 o'clock in the morning driving and spend 12 hours.
Oh, come on.
Classroom to take the test.
Sleep in the car.
No, a long time.
Yeah, and I think we will need a motion for that.
Okay. All right, you want to do them all at the same time?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. I'll make a motion.
Commissioner Scott will make a motion to send Public Works Director Hoskins to the required ongoing training.
Then the other training I got.
For pesticides.
It's.
Set women, Jim. You got a second by Commissioner Pollock. And all those in favor? There you go.
The other one I got is the wastewater conference. I'm required to get continuing education hours each year. And odd years is wastewater.
Even years is treat.
Is what you use to do the water. And certification is July this year for me. And you got to have continuing education hours. And this is not coming up until April. But if we pay for it in February, it is a $50 savings.
Yeah, we'll take that.
But it's a conference. It's going to be held in Louisville at what used to be the executive. What is it now? Crown
Plaza. Yeah.
And that would
I can either drive it and y'all pay my mileage, or I can stay down there because the crap starts at 6 in the morning.
And I think it's up to you.
I think it's going to be a wash on the dollars that you're spending.
Yeah.
Motel room versus my mom.
Right.
So what I would plan on doing here is staying, and unless there was something major going on with wastewater treatment plant.
How many hours do you need? 12 or 24?
24.
24.
So that, if you all see fit to approve that, I can go ahead and register for that and get the $50 off if you do it by February.
I'll have to entertain a motion to send Jim for his ongoing training with the wastewater.
I second.
Commissioner Johnson and second. Commissioner Pollock. All those in favor. You looked like you were going to second it.
No, you said I seconded it.
Well, I was just getting the motion. All right. Does anyone else have anything they'd like to offer? Dave, you got anything else?
No, sir. I want to thank you for having me behind the mobile the last 5, 6, 7 years.
We're glad to have you.
Here, you write your name and number for me, and I'll trade
you. There you go. Hilda, you have anything you'd like to offer? Chad, do you have anything you'd like to offer?
No.
All right. With that, I will entertain a motion to adjourn. Commissioner Pollock, Commissioner Scott seconds the motion. All those in favor? All right. Go Steelers.